Welcome. My name is Marcus. I'm the developer of Tone2 Electra, Gladiator, Icarus, Vanguard, and many other well-known VST plugins. In this episode, I'll explain you how additive synthesis works in Icarus 3. First, I'll show you some patches that use additive synthesis to give you an idea how it sounds. Icarus 3 has been extended with additive synthesis. These modes drastically extend the sonic range, especially for disharmonic and unusual sounds. So in theory, you can rebuild any sound on Earth by stacking a number of sine-waves. In practice, however, this is very difficult, as these sine-waves have to have specific frequencies, phases and volumes. In Icarus, we made additive synthesis accessible and fun to use. We developed smart algorithms that carefully tweak the phase alignment to prevent the occasional volume peaks that competing synthesizers suffer from. I will show you now how to build a sound with additive synthesis from the scratch. First, we initialize a new patch by clicking on the init button. Now we get a patch playing a sawtooth. Additive synthesis usually uses sine waves, so we need to create a sine wave. I got two ways to do this. Either I use the morph knob to remove all partials except the first one from the sawtooth. So here only a sine wave remains. And the second possibility is to use a different waveform. So a sine wave as the basic waveform. We add one octave to play it higher. And then we got additive synthesis mode by clicking here, going to additive. And here you can see a large number of different modes. And the difference between these modes is basically that the tuning and the stereo panning of these modes is different. So we will start here with a bell with 16 partials. And I can change the tuning with the spread knob here. Add some release to the envelope. And the spreading of these partials can be changed here. And you can do also disharmonic ratios. So this is useful for disharmonic sounds. If you use the mouse wheel, it snaps to interesting values that are useful for sound design. And what you can also do is that you modulate this spread value with an envelope or an LFO. So we'll click on the envelope on the LFO here, drag and drop it to the spread knob. So you can do really crazy stuff here. Unlike conventional synthesizers, Icarus 3 is not limited to sine waves, so you can do any waveform you like in combination with the additive synthesis. So we'll remove the modulation here. You can use any waveform or wavetable you like, and you can also combine this with other synthesis modes like FM or samples or syncing, granular, whatever you like. And we'll quickly go through these different modes. So we'll go back to a sine wave here, so you can hear the difference. So this is a bell with 16 partials. The difference to this mode here is that those sine waves are distributed in the stereo field. This is the stereo modes. And here are 8 partials. Stereo distribution, stretched, random, In Icarus, you cannot only do additive synthesis by stacking oscillators within these additive modes here. You can also do this within the waveform itself by editing its partials. So first we start with a new patch by clicking the init button again. And then within the oscillator 1 there is a button called editor, and this one opens the wavetable editor. We'll click here, and then you can see all those waveforms within the wavetable that is currently loaded. We only need a single one, so we click here and trim it, so here only a sawtooth remains. And since we want to do additive synthesis, we initialize it with a sine wave. And here we go. And within the wavetable editor, you can edit the partials of every single waveform by clicking on the spectrum button here. And here you can see that the sine wave only has a single partial. And we'll now build an organ by adding partials. The difference here is that these harmonics that we can draw with our mouse always have integer ratios. So this is the bass frequency, here is the first one, this is And the second one is the bass frequency with double frequency, three times the frequency, four times the frequency. So there's nothing in between. So this is a difference compared to these ratios that are possible with the additive modes here. So you can see that the ratios here are not always integer values. So if you want to do disharmonic sounds, use these modes. And if you want to do additive synthesis with harmonic sounds, use the spectrum here.